It's November and ski season is starting. Many ski resorts are already open and trips are being planned for skiing in Colorado. What are some of the best ski resorts close to Denver, Colorado? That's today's topic, and it's starting right now. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Jill Upleger with Denver Real Estate at RE/MAX Edge in Littleton, Colorado. If you're interested in the Denver area, then you have come to the right place. I post weekly tips, tours, and topics about real estate and living in the Denver area. If you want to see more of my videos, remember to hit that subscribe button. Whether you're a local or traveling to Denver to experience skiing in the Rocky Mountains for the first time, there are many ski resorts to choose from. This video will cover some popular and less well-known ski resorts, details about each resort, and options on how to get there. And if you're looking for an investment property or a second home close to a ski resort, give me a call to learn more. Known worldwide is Vail Ski Resort, 98 miles from Denver. The drive is just over 1 hour 45 minutes. There are over 5,300 skiable acres and 195 trails with something for every skill level. It's the third largest single mountain ski resort in the U.S. Vail is the biggest and most expensive resort in today's video. The Bavarian-inspired town offers 7 miles of hotels, shops, and over 90 restaurants that run along Gore Creek. It's a winter wonderland for an unforgettable vacation. Choose your method of travel to get here. Hire a private limo, take a shuttle, drive, or take the Mustang West bus route. Breckenridge is 82 miles from Denver with a drive time of around 1 hour 35 minutes. The town is a destination all of its own with many shops and restaurants. The terrain is suitable for all skill levels on 3,000 acres spread over 5 peaks. The Imperial Express Super Chair is the highest chairlift in North America at 12,840 feet above sea level. Breckenridge is one of the state's busiest ski areas, so make sure to plan ahead. Options to get to Breckenridge are pretty much the same as Vail. Hire a private car, take a shuttle, drive, or take the Epic Mountain Express bus line. Said to be one of the easiest ski areas to get to is Copper Mountain Resort. The drive is mostly highway and the resort is located just off of I-70. It's 78 miles and about 1 hour 20 minutes from Denver. With about 2,500 skiable acres and 140 trails, there are many options for skiers and snowboarders of all levels. The town of Copper Mountain offers shops, restaurants, and hotels. It's really more of a village though, and doesn't offer a downtown area. But it's a short drive to Frisco or Silverthorne for more dining, lodging, and entertainment options. You can drive or arrange a shuttle to take you here. Winter Park is closer to Denver at only 67 miles, but it will still take 1 hour 20 minutes drive time. Your trip will take you over Berthoud Pass, a winding road with switchbacks to get to Winter Park. It's the oldest continually operating ski resort in the state. There are over 3,000 skiable acres and 166 trails, with the majority geared towards experienced skiers. The Mary Jane section is known for its tree runs and moguls. Downtown Winter Park has an assortment of shops and restaurants. There are plenty of lodging options located at the Ski Base Village, in downtown Winter Park, and the town of Fraser. There are less options when it comes to shuttle service though. The Mustang Craig bus route stops in downtown Winter Park. Here you can transfer onto the free Lyft shuttle to the ski area. During the ski season, you can also ride the Amtrak Winter Park Express train from downtown Denver starting in January. It's a 2-hour trip with one-way fares starting at $29 for the 2022 season. I've included links to Mustang and Amtrak in the description below. If you're looking for a cost-effective way to get to ski resorts, check out Mustang Bus Mountain Routes. Also, starting December 11, 2021, the Snowstang Bus Route will be returning for the 2021-22 ski season. Routes will service Copper Mountain, Loveland Ski Area, Arapahoe Basin, and Howson Hill in Steamboat Springs. We already covered Copper Mountain earlier in this video, so let's quickly review what Loveland, Arapahoe Basin, and Steamboat Springs have to offer. Loveland Ski Area is 57 miles from Denver off I-70 in Dillon. There are 100 trails over 1,800 acres of terrain. It's strictly a ski area. There is no lodging at the base. The closest towns are Silverthorne to the west or Georgetown to the east. Arapahoe Basin, or A Basin, is 64 miles from Denver, 15 minutes from Loveland Ski Area. There are 1,400 acres of skiable terrain with over 150 trails that are geared towards more advanced skiers and snowboarders. If you're looking for extreme terrain, this ski area has it. There are only a handful of runs for beginners. Restaurants and shops are limited here. Steamboat Springs House and Hill is the oldest continuously operating ski resort in North America. It's training grounds for more than 100 Olympians and has the largest ski jumping complex in North America. There are over 50 acres of skiable terrain with 17 alpine and 9 Nordic trails for skill levels from beginners to advanced. There is even night skiing here. These are just a few ski areas that are close to Denver and easy to get to. In peak season, there are over 30 ski resorts operating. What is your favorite ski resort in Colorado and why? Put your comments below. As I mentioned at the beginning, if you're looking for an investment property or second home close to a ski resort, reach out to me to learn more. If you found today's topic helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, comment, and subscribe to my channel so you'll get notifications every time I post a video and you won't miss a thing. Also, if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure to check out some of my other videos showing on the screen. Thanks for watching.